as the set went on, it the adaptation from Blade-wise seemed very apparent.
Very much so. There was a lot of adapting in. Are they doing what I think they're doing?
Okay, well, this is happening. FT, Mike Hayes playing the matchup. Well, at least was trying at the very beginning, but just running back, shooting lasers, doing exactly what he needed to do, staying away from Blade-wise.
Yeah, but this is something that Peach likes to do. This is something Blade-wise very much likes to do. To FD.
Yeah, so I'm just not really understanding of why Mike Hayes chooses to go in when he didn't need to there, and that's racked up a lot of percentage on him when he could have just sat back and waited for Blade-wise to commit to a move just like that. And gets that Nair plane, almost hitting the Shine, unable to get it. Nair out of shield. Incredibly fast option.
A little bit of overcommitment from Mike Hayes. Shining on shield, trying to get the Wave Shine out. You ain't West Balls, you're not that fast. And Blade-wise punishing him with a Nair out of shield. Wow, the follow him.
Goodness.
The follow.
The shimmy from Blade-wise is ridiculous right there. So yeah, it's pretty much just Mike Hayes trying to find a way in, but Blade-wise kind of punishing him for just looking for that way in. And well, see, like, tried to wave back. He's forcing it just a little too hard. Oh my goodness, Blade-wise just barely missing the back air in that situation. Wiggle out air dodge. He's gonna be able to make it back on stage. Mike Hayes off stage is gonna get forward air. Neutral air is fine too. Unable to make it back.
Yep, looking good for Blade-wise right now. He's at 118%, but hey, he gets a grab.
Yeah. Gets a grab, is going to tack on a lot of percent and even have that edge guard opportunity if he gets close enough. Yeah, Mike Hayes just kind of slowing it down. I like it. He definitely has started to figure out that he needs to slow things down a little bit. And just misspaces something. Gets the up smash, though. Mike Hayes.
At the very least, he figured he's going to be trading with that. Worth a trade.
Yeah, so now he's starting to go in again rather than play the lame game, which is starting to work out for him. I wonder if Blade-wise is getting frustrated.
I don't know. Like, the lame game is always very frustrating.
The DI on the up smash was...
Yeah.
That forward tilt was very punishable.
I'm not sure. I don't think he meant to do that forward tilt. It was just part of a pressure thing. He was just kind of like derping out.
Yeah, it just kind of came out on accident. Maybe trying to do a flip cancel nair or maybe a push off the dash tuck. Ooh, reverse up smash, huh? Maybe going for an up tilt, buddy? Trying to do the West Balls? And yeah, see, he's playing this matchup way less aggressive and a lot more patient, and it's working out perfectly.
I see this was definitely looking like Blade-wise advantage at the beginning. But now it's definitely looking like Mike Hayes is going to take this game one here.
Yeah, you know, one stock, like you said earlier, one stock's not an advantage, man.
Yep.
No,
but I mean, the thing is, like, on this stage too, if Blade-wise is going to be on point with his chain grabs, then all he has to do is zero to death this one stock. All he has to do is zero to death this one stock, and he's back to even.
It's totally possible being FD. Oh, just barely getting out of that run-up up smash right there. Good pressure from Mike Hayes. Whew, just barely gets away from that neutral air. Good forward air to be able to get back on stage, but Mike Hayes says, you got to come to me, buddy.
Yeah, Mike Hayes definitely playing the camping game right now.
Yeah, Blade-wise has no other choice, man.
That's going to do it.
First game going to Mike Hayes. We saw this earlier, man. First game went to Mike Hayes, and then Teddy 3-0'd him afterwards.
Yeah, that's true. All right, we're going to Dreamland, the obvious counter pick.
Oh, yeah. A lot of space to maneuver. A lot of space for Blade-wise to recover. Much, much harder for someone to be overwhelmed on such a large stage because, you know, there's so much room. But the problem with that is that also equates to Mike Hayes being able to camp a little bit harder.
Yeah, which is the style that he's really leaning towards today.
Yeah, and it's looking like it's getting him them W's right now.
But 63% to 76%, we're pretty even right now. And just as always...
Ooh, neutral air.
These players, very patient.
Oh, he missed his float cancel. He was unable to get the back air on Mike Hayes' recovery. There's their float right here. Going to try and get the down air and neutral air one more time, but he's got to run to the other side of the stage. He's going to be fine, yeah. There was no real reason for him to run to the other side of the stage, but you gotta make sure sometimes. Yeah, Mike is getting a jab and then just getting back out. That's all he needed to do, and oh my goodness. That killed it 110. It is Peach, though. Nice ledge cancel from Mike Hayes. Trying to keep nice and safe, but he does get down smashed, and oh, there's the grab.
That was a really great re-grab off of a dash attack, and oh, okay. All right, at least it's stage spike. It did the job. It did the job.
Mike Hayes not really looking for the tech because he thought he was going to go the other direction.
Nope.
More than likely, anyway.
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, you don't usually get reversed off of an air like that.
Yeah, it's...
At least not at that trajectory.
Yeah. Mike Hayes definitely finding a lot more ways in, though, than the last few stocks. Just getting around. Ooh, catches the... Oh, no, he does not punish the... It's so hard to punish, though, a B out of shield when there's platforms like that, because he can either go to the platform, he can fake going to the platform, or he can go to the platform and then immediately shield drop out. But Mike Hayes...
Coming in with that wave shine up smash, even up the stocks.
Ooh, the Z drop on the turnip. Oh, up air, that string was almost real. Now, if Mike Hayes has just got to try and rack up as much percentage before his stock ends, is what he's trying to do right here. He does get that platform, so he's going to be able to make it back on after the down smash. Read the roll, but no ability to punish there.
He's got opportunity, and he makes it.
All right, Bladewise up another stock here.
Yeah, this is really what you were talking about, actually, is that Bladewise could just potentially pull this back with a 3-1, just like in winner's side.
Yeah, it's always a potential thing, no matter what. But, you know, Mike Hayes, he definitely seems like he's playing a lot. But, oh, my goodness, that jab almost killed him. Mike Hayes definitely seems like he's playing this this a lot better than he was in the winner's finals, I think.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I agree 100%.
Reverse up smash. Oh, yeah, that was your death. You asked for that one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You went in too deep. You wanted it too much.
He was looking for that second jump, and, you know, Bladewise holding it very wisely. So it's going to be 1-1. Mike Hayes taking off the coat. He's ready to go. Pokemon Stadium is going to be the counter pick. You know, pretty standard Fox counter pick. Yeah. And once again, we're just going to see that campy play style until Mike Hayes thinks he has found a way in, or that he can at least trick Bladewise into doing something committal and then punishing him for it. However, Bladewise just chasing him down and getting racking up that percent real easy. Ooh, nice Z-drop. Got him out of the grab there. And gets off the platform as well. Mike Hayes still trying to be all over him, though. It's neither player can seem to find, like, a safe approach, per se. Neutral air. Yep. Got him on the end of it, though. Up air. It's not going to kill.
All right. And that neutral air, even though it's a reverse neutral air, it's still not quite.
Goodness, NTSC up B.
Come on, let's go. That's got to be it. That's got to be it.
Okay,
all right. Thank you.
65% on Blade
die,
Wise.
Die, Fox, die. Took you forever, but you died.
The bias commentary from the Pacific Northwest right now.
I don't know. I just got to say, I've been awake for like 20 hours. I'm going to slip a little. But, anyway.
I'm just messing with you, man.
Yeah,
it's okay.
I know.
Yeah, so this is one of the reasons that Pokemon... he's got the beam sword.
And I saw Bladewise just kind of, like, scratch his chin and go, do I want this?
Yeah, I think he wants to get rid of it. I think he wants to get rid of it, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
It's over, Anakin. I have the high ground.
I have the tree.
Yeah, so they were just going to hold there for as long until that transformation. But, yeah, Bladewise still having that beam storm. I just don't know if he should keep holding it there. Yeah, he had to get rid of that.
Yeah, in a lot of ways, I feel like the beam sword is...
Oh, the read!
The beam sword is like a more obvious throw or, you know, drop or whatever than any of the other items.
Get out of my head, Charles! All right, sorry. That was really good. He shined him to put pressure on him, and then Bladewise panicked, rolled, and I think it was a wave shine or wave dash out of shield, And then he got the half-charged up smash on him. Ooh, the follow-ups. Oh, nice! The wave dash back. Oh my goodness, Mike Hayes. Pure intimidation.
Really shuffling those back airs. And I think a lot of what, like, court pressure is intended to do is not necessarily to crack your opponent, but it's intended to scare them. And if you use it that way, it's much, much more efficient.
Just barely getting it on the get up. It's crazy how strong up smash is, even if in the sour areas. Yeah, nice. Shine right out of shield, get himself out of that situation. He does get forward smash, though, and now one more down smash. Is he going to be able to make it? No. Soft neutral air, and he's going to grab that ledge. Even it up 62-bit blade-wise. Back to off stage, but he was able to make it back on. Blade-wise, just kind of slowing it down along with Mike Hayes. He's like, this transformation is going to give me enough space.
And Mike Hayes staying right on top of him right now. He wants to take that stock as soon as possible.
Can he get it? Blade-wise, yeah, I was going to say, Blade-wise is usually incredibly good about being able to get back once he has the parasol. And it's an important thing to know as a Peach main, he does wiggle out air dodge out of the up throw up air combo. Or what would have been a combo, I guess. Whew. The neutral air. Another one? Another one. You smart. You loyal. Oh, nope. Dropping it. I guess I gave a little bit of a commentator's curse. My case keeping his composure after being off stage. Gonna get that up smash. Trying to make it happen here.
All right, Mike is really pitching for those up throw up airs.
And he's doing his best to keep him off stage, but eventually Blade-wise always seems to make his way back onto the stage no matter what you try to do to him. It has to be a legitimately just like guaranteed edge guard and nice forward air. He'll take that trade all day.
Now, right now what Blade-wise really doesn't want to happen is he does not want Mike to take this game.
Yeah, because then he's going to be down on counter picks.
He's going to be down on counter picks, and it's going to be tournament stock or tournament match. It'll be tournament match for either of them, but you don't want to be down on counter picks, like even if he wins the next game.
In that case, very smartly playing the laser game. Blade-wise almost finally making his way in there, but he does get up smashed out of shield. Mike Hayes, two games up, and this is what we're talking about. Yeah, gonna go right to Fountain of Dreams. He did win on Dreamland earlier. So yeah, earlier we saw this on game three, I believe. Oh my god, he's got up a bomb! And it just kind of tosses it. It's really hard to just like hit that on people. It's not very often that somebody sees a bomb in your hand and then does something incredibly unsafe that you can throw at it.
Whoa! Dude, the down smash is...
The double down smash! Oh my...
He's like, hey, you're not gonna tech it, man. I'll keep doing it. You keep not teching it, I'll keep doing it. And he's going with a down smash again. He's going crazy with those right now.
It's like Mike Hayes is holding just straight down every time he down smashes. Like, he just happens to get him every time he's, like, trying to do a down tilt or a down B or something. Like,
I mean, well, that's really the trick with the down smash. It's like, when are they going to be holding down? When do they want to down tilt? When do they want to crouch cancel? That's when I down smash.
Yeah. Mike Hayes keeping the pressure on, though. That early stock, nothing to him. Movement still very strong from Mike Hayes. Yeah. Ooh, I spoke too soon. Technical flub. Gets back aired. Is he going to be able to make it back? And he's too low to the ground.
I know he's working those lasers right now. And he really is working the lasers a whole lot more than he usually is. Or than he was in Winners. And it's working out very, very well for him.
Yeah, like I said, he definitely showed that he was willing to camp a lot more than before.
Yeah, which it's really the problem for Peach. And how Blade-wise is saying, yeah, you know what? I'll stay over here. I'm safe over here. And not quite.
Yeah, too high of a percentage to be able to have that to happen.
Too high of a percentage, too good a DI. It's just not going to work out.
And oh, the punish off the up smash there. Very good.
Lots of rogue up smashes.
Yeah, he's really fishing for it. It's kind of like, I feel like it's uncharacteristic of Mike to be so, to fish this hard. Like, he definitely seems like he really, really wants that up smash.
I think the thing is, like, he's normally a much more aggressive player. And he's not a super aggressive player to begin with, but he's definitely forcing himself to be a little bit more campy right now. And see, all of that pressure right there, that was him saying, you know, I'm tired of this. I want the stock gone.
So right there, what Mike Hayes did was so incredibly good and an excellent read. So what happened was Mike Hayes did a jab, and he knew that Peach can neutral air Fox before he gets the up smash in that situation. So he dashed back and then up aired. So when Peach fades forward to neutral air, she falls directly into the second and the hit of the up air. That was whole smart. Oh, nice shine. Can you take it from here? No. Man, it just keeps happening. Every time Bladewise is off stage, he just finds some way to get back on.
Guys, and like the air dodge is really, really powerful for Bladewise. He just seems to always get back on with the air dodge.
Yeah. Mike Hayes taking that stock at about 116 with that up smash. And oh, no. Here's down smash city. Is he going to get back aired? Okay, wave shine all the way. Just get as much damage as he can. Very smart.
Yeah, which right now he basically evened up considering the characters.
Yeah. Ooh, neutral air and up tilt trading right there. Not exactly sure who that favors, to be honest with you. Probably Bladewise for positioning reasons. Not going to be able to get the back air there. Try the full cancel there. He's going to have the ledge, and yeah, forward tilt is angled downwards. And once again, makes it back on the ledge. Try to use the Fountain of Dream. Nice tech. Back air is coming out of my case. He does get neutral air. He's going to make the down smash again. He's on the other side of the screen. Can he make it back before he gets the ledge? No! Bladewise, keep it alive.
All right, 2-2. This is... All right, game. We're going for the last game. Where do you think we're going to go?
Mike Hayes.
Yoshi's Pokemon?
Did Mike Hayes win on Pokemon last time? Because he did take him to Pokemon, so he can't go back to Pokemon.
He did win on Pokemon.
So it's looking like Yoshi's.
Looking like Yoshi's, yeah.
I think.
Oh, that's a down smash stage, too. But, you know, if you know your matchup, you know your stage setup. And we're going to Battlefield.
It's bigger Yoshi's, right?
Bigger Yoshi's. Same general principle applies. He just got more room to avoid it.
But he can't get down smashed here as easily as he would be able to in Yoshi's. Ooh, yeah. Nice read on the down smash there.
Although recovery is definitely going to be a problem, more so for Mike Hayes.
Yeah, due to the lip of the stage. Battlefield known to have those wonky edges.
Because he's going to be going for the sweet spot more often than not. Ooh. And that jab and up smash.
Bladewise not getting the wiggle out air dodge in that. Also putting himself in that position. Trying to read a jump there from Bladewise. Unable to get it. Mike Hayes does not bite. And yeah, he's just running. He's like, I don't need to approach, man. You just need to come to me. But that might be the downfall here. He misses the forward air. Now he's off stage. No, keep stage control. Whoo, neutral air out of the combo. Just going to grab the ledge.
All right, now turnip in hand. He's looking for a chance to use it. Maybe just rack up some damage. Maybe start a combo. Looks like he was expecting him to jump right there with the throw, with the turnip throw up over his head. All right. Bladewise really picking his path right now. And Mike Hayes was jumping around the platforms, and Bladewise is just saying, all right, come on. Somewhere in here, you got to fall through the platforms, and I'm going to hit you with a neutral air.
Yeah, he's trying to chase him, but that's exactly what Mike wants, is he wants him to chase him. And he's picking and choosing the spots very correctly that he knows that Bladewise will... Oh, my goodness. He read the wiggle out air dodge, and he tried to chase him down with it.
The thing was, that
Phantom
was...
hit shine!
That was such a long chase that Bladewise recognized it. If it was a little bit shorter.
Yeah, definitely. There's been so many Phantom hits today, like that I've seen on stream. He does get the push, no forward air due to the tech. Nice job from Mike Hayes staying alive. Yeah, he's just going to sit on those ledges until Bladewise does something about it. He does get the weak spot of the up smash, but can Bladewise make it back down to the ground? He does. Mike Hayes unable to stop him. He does hit him out of the back air. Forward air from Bladewise. He's got him off stage. Neutral air. No, ledge cancel into the back air. Nice trick.
All right, so he's at 96%. He needs to get thrown off stage and edge guarded right now because nothing's really going to kill at 96 except maybe a forward air.
That neutral air might do it, though, due to the back air. Nope. Okay. Yeah, that will.
Yep, that one's going to do it for sure. All right, evened up.
These matches keep going so close.
They're very close. They're very back and forth.
And so Teddy is currently up in sets. I wonder if he's going to be able to keep that going or if we're going to have another. If we're going to have him at 3-3 in sets. Oh, does get the grab here. He's going to be able to tech. He does not read the roll correctly. Back air. No, doesn't get it. And he's going to get shined. He's still got his float. He's going to try and make it back, and he just... Wow, man. I just don't know how he does it every time. Tries to get tack on that extra damage with those lasers. Very smart from Mike Hayes. And, oh, the forward smash. Interesting choice. No real punish, though, off the shield drop. Oh, weak hit a neutral air. Could have been a jab reset. trying to stay just above the lasers, and he's finding a way in with that constant hitbox, but he is going to get up smashed out of the float. It's looking good for Mike Hayes.
He's going to go on to fight West Walls in the grand finals, maybe.
Can Bladewise make this comeback right now? Down part of a stock. He's really trying to push chasing Mike again, and that's what we saw earlier, and that's how we saw Mike really pull through, as he was forcing Bladewise to chase him. And then Bladewise would make a mistake, and Mike would capitalize off it. He does get hit by the smiley. Yeah, he's just tacking on percent. He's like, you know what? You can take my stock, but I'm going to have at least 100% before you do. No, maybe not.
And then Engel is going to make... He moves his stock. 20 plus hours.
Yeah.
All right.
Mopat's been awake for a really long time, guys.
All right, so Bladewise. Bladewise.
And he battlefields himself.
No. No. All right. Oh.
Forward airing off the stage.
Northwest bias. I'm so sad.